navigate this Kwame Brown situation, and I think that might be the best example of how you are different. I know Stack that ran up in the stands. I know Stack that was, you know what I mean, always had the short fuse, and now I'm watching this thing play out with Kwame Brown where you made a joke. He obviously took it personally about his NBA career, and he went on a very long kind of online, I won't call it a rant, but he certainly had a lot to say about you, about Gilbert Arenas, less about Matt Barnes for sure, about Stephen A. Smith and so forth. And there's lots of ways that could go. And to be quite honest, my fear was that this would go somewhere stupid, partly because of who was involved, meaning just a lot of egos, a lot of successful people, but also the outside world piping this thing up, trying to make it something, because people love to see the violence. People love to see the ugliness. How did you make sense of what was happening in the as this was playing out, and how did you decide to deal with it the way you did?
Well, one, the outside world didn't make me. The outside world, they've been killing me my whole career. So the things that they say now, it really don't bother me, because, you know, I've never been nobody's favorite. I'm an underdog. Where I'm at now and the things I'm doing now, Mark, nobody expected me to be here. So I'm good. Kwame was once my teammate. So as a man and where I'm at today, I had to sit back and understand how he felt. I don't want to be a part of somebody bashing another brother for 20 years and be a part of it. I don't want to be a part of that. So as a man, I have no pride in apologizing. I apologize to him publicly because I don't want to be a part of demeaning my brother or putting my brother down. I even hear he's still saying things, but you won't get another reply to me after my apology. Nothing stops this way. We still on Showtime, still got the hottest podcast, still up for a lot of awards. So the only reason I apologize, like I said, because he was one of my brothers. He was one of my teammates, and we don't have a show to demean other NBA players. And when I asked Kwame, well, when he said that, he said, y'all demean Kwame Brown. And I apologize, we did. But we never demeaned anybody else, because this is an avenue for other NBA players and for athletes. That's why we have everybody on our show, and we've gotten everybody on our show, and people still want to come on our show, because as an athlete, it's a place for athletes to create their own narrative. And that's what we've been doing. And we created our own narrative. And that's why people see the change in me, because this is not a show where we speak the way other shows speak. We do things differently. We do it from the culture. And that's how we got so famous, and why our show is winning, because it's unfiltered and we show love. And so I had no problem apologizing to Kwame. And that's why I never took it to the streets. Mark, like you said, I'm really from the streets. I've been in some really street stuff. You know what I mean? You can Google me. There's no mystery in my history. So there's no need for me to be tough or talk about guns or talk about stuff like that, because I'm not there. I'm trying to uplift my brothers. And what I stand for today has nothing to do with fighting or hurting another brother. They can have that. The media can have that. Social media can have that. I have a blessed life. I got a lot of great things going. And if it's not about empowerment, if it's not about continuing to uplift my brother Georgie, if it's not about helping Gigi continue to smile and benefit Gigi life, where she can go on to college and live her dreams and become the doctor she want to be, I could care less about it, man. All the smoke is going to continue to go on. Our lives are going to continue to go on. And Kwame Brown, is number love to him, man. Like I said, I apologize. And it's kind of dead with me, but they can keep it going on, man. I'm just not a part of bringing my brother down. I never will be.
No, I think that's the right approach. I'm only going to ask you one more question on this, just for clarity, so my audience understands. He hasn't really accepted the apology yet. Do you expect him to accept the apology? Because I'm not speaking for you, I'm speaking for me. People make mistakes in public. I actually think, given all the things that have been said about him, what you said was relatively minor. And I think, you know, Matt Barnes tapping your leg, relatively minor. You apologize publicly, which is a very big thing. It seems to me that maybe the reaction has less to do with what you said and more about the 20 years of a whole community giving him a hard time. What can we do to make this work? What can we do to heal this? What can we do to bring you brothers together to get him to accept the apology or make this work?
Well, I mean, one thing about it, you know, what I've learned as a man and as a 43-year-old man, you don't apologize for the person to accept your apology. You apologize because you did wrong, or whether he accepted it or not, that's on him. I did my part. We've spoken on DM. We didn't speak personally on the phone, but we spoke through DMs, and he can share the messages. We spoke through the DMs. I have no problem with none of that. because I'm a man and I'm firm on who I am and where I stand and what I've done in my life. So I'm not gonna egg it on. I'm not really gonna speak. And if he accept the apology or not, that's on him. I apologize. I did my part, Mark.
That's all you could do. Well, I'm happy that All the Smoke is coming back for another season. I watch every episode. I think you need some more Philadelphia.